Hi everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to renew your Indian passport in USA with CKGS. Here I'm going to show you step-by-step instructions about the process. If you want to know more information about the process, please visit simplewordsforyou.com website. If your passport is within 1 year before the passport expiration date, please start the process immediately. Here you have two options. One regular, second one Tatkal. Let's say if you have some emergency, please go with Tatkal process. It will take around 3 to 4 days. Please click on this link here. It is going to take you to CKGS website. First thing is you need to provide your state of residence. So based on that one, it is going to show you which location you need to go and what are the steps involved in the Tatkal process. Okay, let's close this one and let's check. I mean, suppose if you want to do it in regular processing, what are the steps you need to do, or like which location you need to go? So let's say you are someone who is living in Delaware. You need to go to Washington DC processing center, or you can ship your pack application to Washington DC. Either you can go directly to that location, or you can ship your package application, as I said before. First thing is you need to go to CKGS website and first go to home page. If you scroll down little bit, here you can see whether you can choose Tatkal service or either you can go with regular services. So both options are just side by side. Please, like here we want to planning to do regular processing here. So let's click on it. Next, it is going to take you to this page where you need to provide your basic information. So let's say first we are going to with normal process. Which state are you living in? So they are just saying that they've made some changes to government NRA passport application website. Now it's more automated. So they incorporated so much automation in the process. So that's a cool thing. Okay, let's close this. This is pretty much all basic information about you, like marital status. So let's say if you want 36 pages booklet or 60 pages booklet, the pricing is different for 36 and 60 pages. Keep that in mind. Next, let's say if your passport is already exhausted, the pages are exhausted, still with valid passport expiration date, choose first option. Your passport already expires, go with second option. If it is going to expire, third option. Here we don't have much options here, just you have to select that. Next, in case if your passport is lost or damaged, please go with one of those options. Coming to miscellaneous services, let's say if you have a change, you recently changed your address, or if you want to change your date of birth, place of birth, name, or your parents' name, please select yes here. And don't forget to include photocopy of that address proof. Photocopy or original, whatever it is like. They will mention that documents in the checklist. Coming to applicant details, here you need to give your basic information along with your passport information. In case if your application is pending with USCIS, you need to give your application number here. Let's say there is change in your appearance or signature, you need to select yes, and at the end of the process it is going to generate some forms for you, which you need to notarize it as well. Next, coming to submission and contact details. If you are planning to go directly to that location, then you can select walk-in, otherwise you can choose shipping here. And also mode of payment there, contact details. Once you click on proceed, it is going to generate a temporary ID for you. This is helpful if you want to come back and continue your process. Once you click on proceed, it is going to take you to Government of India NR application form. So let's go to Government of India NR application form. Here you need to fill your form. So the process will take you to this page. Let's click on the first link here, which is online registration form. Here you need to provide your online registration information here, some of the like applicant information, and also your address details as well. So you can see at the bottom there is a temporary application ID, which is helpful for you in case if you want to come back and continue your process. Once you click on save and continue, it is going to take you to next step. And then after doing everything, it is take you back again to CKGS website. You will see all your supplemental forms and letters under your account at CKGS website. Some of them you need to self-attest, some of them you need to notarize. Which ones you need to self-attest, which ones you need to notarize are clearly mentioned in checklist. And also you need to tick the appropriate boxes in the checklist saying that you included so and so documents in the application, and don't forget to include that copy, checklist copy, along with your application package. Either you can ship directly by yourself or you can use a CKGS service. CKGS servicing is pretty good. Next, coming to fees, it's mentioned already at CKGS website what are the fees for different options. And at the end of the process also, you can see the appropriate fees. Here are some of the basic definitions like ECNR and ECR. You will come through these terms while doing the forms. So let's say ECNR means immigration check not required. ECR means immigration check required. Passports issued after Jan 2017 without any notation means ECNR. I believe I covered everything except the passport photo details requirements. If you go to any nearby Walgreens location, they will get your job done. It's a 2x2 inch size passport size photo. So here they clearly mentioned about do's and don'ts along with some sample images. Please take a look at it. Let's close this one and go to some of the most frequent or common mistakes usually so many applicants do. So if you do a small mistake also, you need to completely redo the process. So it's not worth. So please keep that in mind. Please have a glimpse at this list. I believe I covered pretty much everything. If you have any further questions, please feel free to reach me at simplewordsforyou.com website. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope this helps. Thanks.